So now we're gonna have some further adventures with the Möbius strip. So I'm gonna say, what if, like I said, I got a pen and kind of drew a line like halfway along this strip and went all the way round and kept going. What if we cut down that line? If you can try this at home. If you get some scissors, you cut halfway along and then you cut all the way around. I'm not about to do it live because it might go horribly wrong, but here is one that I prepared before the live stream. When you cut all the way around, what you get is this. And if you don't believe me, please feel free to, you know, make a Möbius strip at home. And now you might be a bit surprised by this because you might expect two things, but this is one thing. And it kind of links to the idea that the Möbius strip only has one side. So when you cut it in half, you get one thing. And this actually has four twists in, whereas the original one had one twist in.
So this is an elliptic curve. It says y squared equals x cubed minus 2x plus 2. Cool, okay. What are we going to do for this one?
Right, so the first thing is another good thing to look out for with getting graphs is always symmetry. So what we can do here is we write this as, this is the same as y equals plus or minus the root of x cubed minus 2x plus 2. So anytime we have any solution for x, what we can just do is flip it, sort of reflect it in the x-axis. So anything that's sort of on top here will also be reflected here, which makes life a bit easier, because all we have to really consider is just the top, which isn't too bad. And then there's also something to just watch out for in general, which really makes drawing these elliptic curves, you get quite a variety of interesting curves, is this cubic function here. There's no guarantee really of what this does. Like, you can get cubic functions that will be, for parts of it, it'll be underneath, and for these parts where it's underneath, well, you're gonna have y squared equals something negative, which is just not gonna, it's literally gonna be like a sort of a gap in the thing. So what you have to do is make sure you're leaving gaps at any parts where this sort of cubic becomes negative, and then you can have all sorts of weird things.
So our frog is going to jump either left or right with probability of a half. So this is symmetrical, it can go either direction, and it's on the infinite line of lily pads, so it's not going to win or lose, it's not going to get somewhere and stop, it's just going to keep going forever. And we're going to ask a question about our frog. And the question I want to know is, will my frog ever return to where it started? And there's a bit of a clue for you in that we've done all the hard maths we need to do. So what we need to do now is recognise how we can use the maths we did in the Gambler's Ruin for this frog problem.